Crazy Russian Dad here. My American fanatics ask, tell us about life under in the Soviet Union. So today I want to highlight one particular aspect, which is nationality, okay? Nationality, if you look in your American passport, okay, if you have one around, but if you don't, I will tell you. Under nationality, what do you see? You may know. You see three letters, USA, okay? Whether you're white or black or anything else, whether you, whatever gods you worship or don't worship, it will still say USA. That's not how it was in Soviet Russia. Nationality basically contained your ethnicity, okay? So let me explain how it was. Oh yeah, so it was basically your nationality could have been a Russian. It could have been Ukrainian, it could be Belarusian, it could be Jew, it could be Georgian, okay? So these were all, they were all seen as ethnicities, okay? It's based on the, sorry, bad traffic, basically based on your bloodline, okay? So if so that's how it worked. If both of your parents were, say, Russian, then you would be written as Russian in the nationality. By the way, it was interesting, it was paragraph item number 5. That's why there were many jokes in Russia about the fifth paragraph. I will tell you more. But if one of your if your parents have different nationalities in their own passports, then you could pick one. Okay, so if your mother is, I don't know, Russian and father is Ukrainian, you had your choice. You could write yourself as Russian or Ukrainian. Okay, there was no choice in my case. My mother Jewish and my father Jewish, therefore they wrote Jewish in my passport, okay? And of course, I mean, I think the reason they did this is because they wanted to know who was who so they could discriminate, both, you know, officially and officially and unofficially, right? I mean, it's kind of ridiculous because it's like a bloodline. It's like, I feel like, what is this? Am I like stallion, the horse that the sort of tracing the bloodline all the way from the great Arabian the stallion? Don't know. Anyway, so, but that's how it was. Nationality was something that was written into your passport. Had nothing to do with religion, okay? Had everything to do with what the nationalities of your parents were, and basically by blood. They kind of, it's interesting in that regard. The Nazis did something, they were also obsessed, but for different reasons, with the whole being pure Aryan and Ubermensch and all that. I don't think communists were interested in Ubermensches. I mean, there was this sort of the concept of the builder of communism, but it wasn't by the bloodline. So, but nationality was used. Where was it used? Everywhere. Basically, wherever, you know, if you wanted to go to university or if you wanted to get a job, one of the things they looked at, first thing they looked at is your, what they call the fifth paragraph, right? As in, they looked at your nationality, because there were quotas. You know what quotas are? I've had my share of that. It's basically, you would know that in this university, out of 100 people, you can only, say, take 2 Jews and, I don't know, 3 Georgians. I don't know who received those quotas. I mean, it wasn't completely publicized, but it was known. Like, there were some universities or colleges where they would not accept Jews at all. And that was well known, right? Like, you had to be, I don't know, Albert Einstein and the brother of the university president or something like that. In my own case, it's actually quite funny. I remember applying to this university in St. Petersburg. And by the way, there were entrance exams. In Russia, the way you enter universities, you need to take exams and show that you know stuff. So there were 3 or 4 exams, like Russian, math, physics, and something else. I forget. So I remember halfway through those exams, I remember going there to see what my results were. And all of a sudden, I see people that need to go and see the, people who accept, anyways, to see some kind of a university officer. All of a sudden, I almost passed out. I see my name, but I need to see this person. So I go, you know, my legs are barely bending. I knock and I go in there, and it's a sort of the fatherly figure, imposing gentleman. He walks me into his office. He says, please sit down. How are you? I'm like, okay. And then he proceeds to tell me just what an important university it is, and how they do the work of the party, and how the scientific breakthroughs will help the Soviet Union for decades and, you know, centuries to come. I'm nodding because so far it's good. I mean, he didn't tell me anything bad, the usual stuff. And then he proceeds to tell me what an important role the university plays, and that how lasers and holographs and God knows what else they study and teach and research will help the country. And again, I nod, I say, yes, yes, sir, great, so far so good. Again, nothing bad. And then he's like, what, don't you get it? And I'm like, no, sorry. And I'm like, I feel really ashamed because I don't get any of this, meaning I get all of it, I said, but I don't know how this applies to me, sir. And it was interesting episode of my life. He walks to the door, make sure it's really closed. He locks it. And then I'm like, oh my God, what's going on here? And he finally tells me, listen, you have applied for this particular department of laser optics, okay? But you understand that we cannot accept you there. And I am completely lost because I'm 16 years old. I graduated at 16, just anyway, it happened. And so I'm like, no, I don't understand. He's like, well, you understand, you're Jewish. And then it dawns on me that all this lecture about stuff was just to tell me that they cannot actually accept me. But this person was nice enough to sort of tell me that to my face. And then I said, well, and then I had the moment of clarity. And I said, sir, is there some other department where you could accept somebody like me? Right, we're speaking in code. And he said, yes, instead of laser optics, you need to write in, I don't know, spectral something in holography. I said, that sounds very nice. And I wrote in spectral holography and all of that, and they switched me. Now, it amused me more than anything, but he was probably a good guy who was trying to play by the rules, but still do a nice thing for this boy, which was me. But could have been a tragedy. I knew plenty of people who were incredibly bright, who were the next Albert Einstein, who just could not enter the university because of their nationality, because they were Jew or somebody else like that. They would just make sure during those entrance exams, they would make sure that you would fail. Okay, once you've answered the questions, you could always ask one more question. Eventually, there is something even Albert Einstein would not answer. I keep picking Albert Einstein just in the sense that he was smart. So this nationality thing is, on the one hand, it's just like one word in your passport. On the other hand, like, it's a bunch of discrimination that happened. Okay, so I'm really glad that here in America, and maybe that's how it is in Russia now. I don't know. I don't have. They made me renounce my citizenship when I left because it was still Soviet Union, and I was, I don't know, enemy of the people or something. So that's nationality for you. There you go. It's good. Be proud that nationality in your passport says USA. Okay.